Hi everyone, and welcome to this Facebook Live. What to do when the world is divided? Let me know in the comments below. If you are watching the replay, type in hashtag replay. And well, this is hi Anju, good to have you live with me. So 2020 has been a challenging year, and especially the last couple of months, like, you know, since the entire COVID situation showed up. And then to top it all, you have you have all these all the stuff going on in the world around you, where there is so much of divisiveness, there is so much of it's just a divide, you know, it's just a divide based on the color of your skin, based on, hi Angelique, hi Leslie, hi everyone, hi Susanna. So there is so much of this separation, there is so much of this division, and everything which is going on in the world around us. It seems like sometimes when I think about it, it seems like, you know, I'm living in my worst nightmare, as it were, you know. But one of the things that I like to kind of look at, the way I want to look at this whole situation, is that this is a chance for us to really see what points of views that we are operating from. What are the thoughts, feelings, and emotions that we have? So if anything that is going on around us is affecting us, it's bothering us, it's triggering us, it's bringing up all these thoughts, feelings, and emotions within us, then notice the central character here is actually me. Everything is actually happening within me, okay? And these situations outside, they are just pushing my buttons. These situations outside are just like trigger points for me, right? And so you know, It's like a great, great opportunity for me to actually look at all these trigger points within me. Look at all these buttons within me which are being pushed. And then, you know, identify each one of these buttons and, you know, use whatever tool that you have at your disposal, you know, all the tools that you have in your beautiful toolkit, and just, you know, let go of these points of views. Like, literally, I've spent time where, you know, I will scroll through Facebook for the sole purpose of finding things that actually trigger me. And once I find those things that trigger me, I just sit and I just clear those things, you know. And, you know, it's very interesting to see, like, suddenly I'll be in a good place, and then I'll scroll through Facebook, and then suddenly I will find, I'll just go blah, you know, I'll just contract, I will just shrink in place. And then, you know, I might not even notice that, right? I might notice it like maybe 10, 15 minutes down the road. And then I go, oh, wait a minute, what happened? What caused me to contract? Just that question, what caused me to contract? What created that thing for me? And immediately, you know, I can find that point at which, you know, that reaction occurred within me. And so I've literally, you know, spent time on Facebook looking for these trigger points. And then once I find these things that trigger me, I will just clear those things on myself. Like, you know, of course, all of us are really attached to our homeland, you know, the place that we originate from. So in this entire situation with the lockdown and everything, I've been looking at the pain and suffering of you know, the migrants who were stuck in cities without any job, without any money and so on, and them wanting to go to their villages and all the incredible difficulties that they were facing. And I found myself you know, really getting triggered by all of that, being affected by all of that. And what I started to do was that I just started to clear all those points of views within me. So right now, you know, how many of you are actually witnessing what is going on around and are being affected by it? Okay, and so what if you were to just, you know, in this moment right now, just get a pen and paper and just write down whatever is bothering you, and then just use the tools at your you know, within your toolkit, and just, you know, destroy and uncreate those things, or, you know, release on those things or whatever. See, the thing is that we get affected by things outside of us because they are triggering our own you know, inner pain. And what we are always trying to do is to avoid that inner pain. But what if we didn't avoid that pain anymore, right? What if we actually acknowledged that pain? We actually just, you know, said, okay, this is a point, this is the pain point within me. And, you know, let me just, you know, let go of this pain point. And this has been something which has really helped me a lot. Like, you know, when the entire situation with the lockdown happened, my son was actually in the UK, and he was to travel, and just one day before the borders closed in the UAE, and he couldn't come here. So I went through some days of so much anxiety, and then I said, you know what, this is something, the anxiety is my pain point. So what if I could just, you know, keep letting go of my anxiety? And that's exactly what I did. I just spent some time in letting go of my own anxiety. And the moment my anxiety went, you know, I just became peaceful. So I got that freedom. So the thing is that the external situation around us is what it is. And instead of trying to change the external situation so that you can feel okay with it, what if, you know, you did it the other way around? What if you went inside and found all those triggers within you which are causing you to react to the external situation? Because as long as, you know, we function from this point of view that the external situation has to change in order for me to feel better, then, you know, you are always caught up in that thing of trying to fix things, trying to change things or whatever. Like one of my friends, she just messaged me in the morning. She said, you know, I've heard this thing of a cyclone coming in Mumbai. So can we do something to change it? And I said, you know what? Why don't you instead look at what that is bringing up for you? And why don't you just, you know, start to clear all those points of views? Because here's the thing, the more that we clear all these thoughts, feelings, emotions, and stuff that is going on within us, the more that we start to get free, and the more that you are free, then, you know, it spreads to everyone who is around you. And so it kind of is like those concentric circles which is spreading, you know. So find your own balance, find your own peace, and then you will find that everything around you changes. And you know, we have such amazing tools which are available with us. these are such amazing tools that can change any points of views, any thoughts, any feelings, any emotions. So pretty much these days, that's all that I do. I just look at where I am reacting to things. And I just start, you know, clearing all that. And very quickly, once all those things are clear, what I find is that no matter what is going on around me, I can be in a balanced place. So how many of you can actually relate to that? Like, I know this is like a really difficult topic, and with the tools that we have, it's really easy to say, oh, you know, let me go and change the external situation. But just for today, you know, play with this particular tool, this tool of actually just, you know, looking inwards and looking at everything that is triggering me, everything that is bothering me, you know, anything in the news that, I mean, of course, I don't watch news much. The only news that I get, it's all coming through social media, okay? So just that thing of whatever triggers me, I just start clearing it, and things have just been shifting and changing a lot for me. Okay, so I hope that helped you guys, and I also wanted to invite you to a group healing program that I'm doing. It's called the 21 Days of Group Energetic Releases, and basically, you know, I will be doing energetic releases on the entire group, and it starts on the 4th of June. But I've had a lot of people who've already joined, and you know, I just started doing the releases right from the get-go, and just, you know, within 2-3 days of joining, people are experiencing such incredible shifts. And one of the biggest things that people start to notice is really that sense of inner peace and inner balance. And I've had people tell me things like, I feel like I'm myself after so many months, yeah? And you know, telling me things like, you know, I had lost all my motivation, and then suddenly I find that I'm doing things and I'm just, you know, going ahead and not stuck anymore. So, you know, people have had amazing changes in the physical pain in their body. Their relationships have been transformed. And this is just like literally within 7 days, sometimes even 2-3 days, people have, received new possibilities. Like, they've been invited to interview for a higher job within their own organization and things like that. So if this is something that talks to you, I would love to have you guys join me. It only costs $33 for these 21 days. And the thing is, you don't have to do anything. Like, there's not going to be any Facebook Lives. There's not going to be any calls that you have to get on, any replays that you have to listen to. It's just a group healing session. So as soon as you sign up, I will add you to my list. And then every day in my morning, 5:30, I do the healing. And after the healing is done, I'll send you a message saying that the healing is done. This is a group healing session. If you want to join this with your family, then for 4 people it costs $100. So if this is something that is an invitation for you, I would love to have you join me, and we begin on the 4th of June. The link is in the description. So thank you so much for listening to me, and I'll see you around. Bye.